So, first step is putting on our waders. So you can see we have high socks on and we tuck our scrub bottoms into it. We also tuck our shirts into our pants. And then obviously we pull our waders on. Now you have to clip the waders up at the top. And then we also have a belt that you are going to see me struggle with in probably 3, 2, 1. Yep, can't find it. Once I found it, can't find the other hole to put it in. But yeah, so waders are everyday uniform. And though they are not the most flattering of outfits, they definitely help protect us from the elements and all the water and muck we're going to be climbing into in a couple of seconds. So here's us getting ready for the day. Then we are off. So we are on our trail, walking out to our field sites. We are clearly very excited to be starting our first day. And you can see that we have a little small pack with us. Everybody in this little pack today is going to be learning how to track.
So you want to get it up to here, but you want to leave enough breathing room so that way obviously the turtles can come up and breathe or anything else that gets stuck in there. When you put it down too, make sure that it's not sitting on top of any grasses that's keeping it up above the water. So like say if there's a big snapper or many turtles in there and it sinks down, you still have some room to play with in terms of air breathing. So look for, you know, good pathways, calm turtle highways. You don't want to put them too close to shore in case raccoons can come along and yank the trap out and steal our bait. Not fun. But anywhere, like in here in Spring Bluff, is good to medium hoop trap opened at this time. And so when you go to check the traps, you'll take the GPS coordinate for whichever trap you walk up first to, and then right up there. You always want to try and encapsulate the longest point on their carapace or on their plastron, so always make sure that you're doing it long ways and not like this, because then one point over here could be longer than the other. So always try to encapsulate the longest area possible. So I like to pull the calipers towards me like this. Some people like to do it the opposite way, where they push it all the way up to you. But sometimes it helps to keep the turtle with their head more closer to the calipers, so they kind of stay tucked in more. But also same thing when you do it widthwise. Try and encapsulate the widest area possible, so that way we get a better representation. Yeah, something like that. So all around too. There's another measurement in there that's called shell height. We call it sandwich.
Turtle sandwich.
You're just gonna take the tallest point, so always try to encapsulate the longest, tallest point. I guess this one.
Sounds good. Cool. Oh, you got blood. So there is lymph in it, yep. So I'm gonna have you pull out. So, when that happens, I don't know where your cap is, right here. The lymph blood can still be used for the plasma tubes.
Okay.
So we just put that in there. And then we have to do again.
So where else? Like.
Can you see?
Yes.
So you're gonna go all around. You're gonna do the tongue, you're gonna do the roof of our mouth, you're gonna just shove it in.
Shove it in.
There we go. Grab it out. And then finagle their tail out. And yep, grab it.
After we swab the turtle's mouth, we also swab the cloaca. While this is not a difficult test to perform, it does take practice and dexterity to make sure that the swabs don't accidentally touch anything that would contaminate our sample. Here you can see Sam helping me by holding on to the swabs after I take the sample. Later you will see us hold the swabs in many different ways, depending both on personal preference and turtle activity level to protect them from contamination.
Snap these in the juice.
track, and Timmy is teaching her because tracking is not my best talent. I try, and I know how, but Timmy is by far a better teacher, so he is being lovely and teaching Kayla the 101 on tracking.
Yeah.
You're gonna get a more specific range.
Okay.
Of where she is, whereas if you put it like this, you're gonna get your V.
Oh, okay.
But also some people like to do it like this. Yeah,
so do it like this is what you're telling me.
Yes.
I always like to do it like this. And then you like to bounce around, you know, think of where but if you're holding it still straight up in the air and you're getting signal, then she might be a little bit farther. But if you start angling it down and you're getting good signal, then she's probably going to be pretty good. But if you're still high up the chain and you're getting signal pointing down at you, then you're too high up. That's the ultimate.
Let go.
Hello.
Yes.
How excited.
Yay. Look at how excited you are. Hi. Oh my gosh. Yay, a landing is out.
All right. So now we are seeing a transmitter being replaced on a turtle. So these transmitters only have a certain amount of battery life. We write down each one when they were put on a turtle and approximately about when they're going to be replaced, because the worst case scenario would be if a transmitter died and then we couldn't find the turtle ever again. So what we like to do is, even before the battery says it's going to expire, we like to take the old one off and put a new one on. So here you can see Timmy. He is unscrewing the screws of the first set, and he's soon going to be replacing it with the second set, so that way we can find this turtle for a long time to come.
Yes, I'll come back to you. What happened? What's that?
I lost my shoe.
What?
On day one. it's not helpful anymore.
It's beautiful.
Thanks.
Where's your other shoe?
It's stuck in the mud. It's still solid.
Okay.
We got one shoe.
Okay, progress forward.
Part of the reason that I had so much trouble with this pair of boots is that they are Velcro. And as soon as the Velcro got wet, it no longer stuck together. So my boot would just fall off my foot. Well, until it broke.
Hey Kayla, can I see your sock?
Oh yeah.
Beautiful.
This one's still okay. I just can't tie. In the arms of the angel, fly away from here, from this dark
hotel. What you doing, Kayla?
So right now I am trying to find another pair of boots. Because, as you saw, my boots are not used anymore.
So, yeah, it's like 7:30 in the morning before work. We came to Walmart to try and get new shoes for Kayla.
Yes.
How are they looking?
I don't know if they are big enough for the sock to fit in.
So Kayla currently has a turtle. We just caught one in one of her traps. Ta-da! So step one is getting swabs. Now this guy is a little cranky, so he doesn't want to open his shell. So we are going to watch how Kayla masterfully opens his shell to get the mouth swabs.
One trick we use to avoid some of these turtles completely hiding in their shell is to hold on to one of their arms. Holding an arm out of the shell allows us to better visualize their mouth, so that we can gently use the probe to encourage them to open their mouth so that we can take our swabs.
Thank you.
where's the footage from Wednesday?
Well, you see, Kayla and I got the lovely task of sampling over 40 Head Start turtles today and doing all of the lab work. So it is currently 2:00 in the morning. So I guess technically it's a Thursday vlog because we have finally just finished doing all of the lab work for all of the turtles that we sampled today. So, yep, it's 2:00 in the morning. We're gonna go home, get a couple hours of sleep, and then be out tomorrow morning to sample some more turtles. So that's it for Wednesday. Sorry it wasn't more exciting, but it was so crazy we didn't get any footage. Oops.
So here are those adorable baby head starts that we had to sample with their little telemetry sets on. And now you're going to see me and Kayla doing physical exams and sampling side by side. So we got these two turtles in one trap. So one for Kayla and one for me. You can see I'm swabbing the big girl's mouth right now, and Kayla is trying to open up the little guy. Sometimes the little guys can be a little bit more stubborn, so it takes a little bit more time because you have to be more careful. So as you can see, I'm doing the cloacal swab, and Kayla has moved on to drawing blood because little guy did not want to open up his mouth. So as you can see, we're on a pile of land right now. Obviously, that's not where these turtles were caught. They were caught in medium-sized hoop traps in streams throughout the wetlands. But as soon as we get these turtles, Kayla and I try to find the nearest piece of land to sample them on. We were pretty lucky this time, and we actually weren't that far from flat land that was completely dry, not even a little bit wet. But sometimes we have to get creative, and we're sitting on a tree stump, or we're sitting on a tree that's fallen in the middle of water. Right now, we got pretty lucky. We have a big enough spot that we can both spread out and have access to all of our supplies without having to worry about dunking our backpacks in water, which has happened, and I'm sure will happen this summer, and you guys will get to see it. But yeah, this is just a little tiny peek of what sampling looks like for us. We're definitely going to go into more detail about what samples we take on these guys and why we take them, but for now, enjoy this lovely clip of us working together, getting some samples, measuring the turtles, and just having some fun while we're doing it. Fun fact, here you see me reaching for my phone and then realizing that it's being used to record this video. But we reach for our phones, and you may see us on our phones in this vlog because that is where we keep our veterinary data sheets and also how we access Lake County's system of turtles and telemetry. So obviously I was looking at my turtle to see any abnormalities upon physical exam, but any of those abnormalities we take note of on our veterinary exam sheet. So we have our phones out, not because we're texting on our vlog, but because we are recording valuable information on all of our cute little turtle friends. you didn't really get to see much of us doing lab work because we really wanted to focus on Kayla's first week out in the field, what it's like to be out in the field, and our triumphs and tribulations during this week. So here's just a sneak peek at some of the lab work that we do. Kayla right now is doing some blood smears, and then she's going to be doing PCV TPs. Don't worry, we're going to film a video later on what all of these fancy words mean and why we do lab work here in Lake County, but we figured that we would include some little clips of what we do every day after we return from the field.
Here we see Sam very carefully filling hemocytometers. As she mentioned, we'll talk more about what a hemocytometer is and why we do this kind of lab work later. But right now, she's just setting up so that she can start counting cells.
We just wanted to label some tubes.